Do you remember this thing? This cheap cardboard box that you slide your phone into was the first taste of VR for a lot of people, myself included, way back in 2015. At the time, it was mind-blowing. It really felt like VR was the future, specifically VR gaming. But it's pretty safe to say now that we were wrong. For a lot of reasons, VR gaming has remained a very niche thing. Some people are into it, and everyone else has more or less forgotten about it. The future of VR gaming is uncertain, which makes me, as a Beat Saber addict, kind of nervous. So it would be really nice if I could do something to make sure that my VR games remain playable for as long as possible. Now, a few weeks ago, I made a video about why game piracy, under the right circumstances, is justified. Why you should run your pirated games on a Linux-based operating system rather than Windows, and how to go about doing that. All of that applies, maybe even more so, to VR games. But unfortunately, VR games are just more difficult to run on Linux. There's a wide variety of VR headsets out there, most of which don't officially support Linux, which means we need even more software to help bridge that compatibility gap. And there's just not as many people developing and using that software, so the experience overall is less user-friendly. That said, I'm going to show you one possible set of steps you could take to play PC VR games on Linux based on my experiences. Now, the headset that I have is a MetaQuest 3S, but the steps I'm going to show you should work on most Android-based standalone headsets. If you have a different type of headset, like an Oculus, you'll probably still find some of this useful because the software we're going to use is supposed to work with a lot of different headsets. I just obviously can't test all of them. Before we get started, I should mention two more things. Number one, the point of my last video and of this one is to show you how to play games in a way that gives you actual freedom and ownership, but my choice of headset kind of invalidates all of that. Meta headsets are unusable without a Meta account, which means someday the hardware I bought and paid for will turn into a paperweight overnight for no good reason. If I could have bought something else, I would have. But the VR landscape is looking pretty bleak and there just weren't any other good options in my price range. If you can find some other headset from a company that actually respects its users and that is compatible with the steps that I'm about to show you, please buy one of those instead and avoid giving the Zuck your money. I'll leave links in the description to the Linux VR Adventures Wiki, which should have information about different types of headsets and whether you can get them to work on Linux. That website is really the only resource you need. In fact, if you prefer reading instead of watching, you might as well just look at the description now and go there instead, because they've done an incredible job of documenting all of this. Number two, I'm not going to retread old ground. So as a prerequisite, I'm going to assume that you've already installed a pirated or otherwise DRM-free VR game, and that you've already added it to Lutris on your Linux PC. If you don't understand what I've just said, I suggest watching my last video, which goes over the steps involved. If you have followed along, then your setup should be similar to what I have here. As you can see, I have Beat Saber installed in Lutris, and the configuration is more or less what you would expect. Obviously, if I tried launching it right now, it wouldn't work, because we haven't done anything VR specific yet. Now, getting Windows VR games to run on Linux is not easy. With regular games, you just need Proton. It's the gold standard, and there really isn't any alternative. With VR games, you need a couple of additional components on top of that. Number one, you need what's called an OpenXR runtime. And number two, you need a way to connect and stream content from your PC to your headset. If you were trying to run a game through Steam, then you would use the Steam VR runtime, and you would need to combine that with something like ALVR to stream to the headset. But Steam VR is proprietary and it requires Steam, so in keeping with the theme of these videos, that's not the direction that we're going to go in. Instead, we'll use an open source XR runtime called Monado, plus a piece of software called Wyvern to stream to the headset. If that sounds complicated, it kind of is. Luckily, there's an app called Envision that makes things dead simple. It gives us a friendly UI and it does all the work behind the scenes. So the first thing you need to do is install the thing. It's probably available on your distro's app store, and if not, you can get an app image from their website. Once it's installed, you can open it, and the first thing to do is to make sure that the little drop-down at the bottom says Wyvern. If you have a non-Android-based headset, you should look into the other options, because there's a good chance that one of them will be what you want. Then you need to click on Build Profile. either through the menu button on the top right, or it might just be the first button at the top. This is going to start a process that will take a while, and you may be asked to enter your password or install some other packages through your distro's package manager first, but eventually you should see a success message and you can close the dialog box. The next step is to open up the debug view as shown here. Click on the button with the three dots and click on where it says copy profile environment variables. Open up a text editor and hit paste. You should see a couple of lines that you need to copy into your game configuration in Lutris. So go to Lutris, right click on the game, go to configuration, and under system options, just paste in those two variables in the way that I'm doing here. Finally, you need to go to runner options and make sure you've selected Proton Experimental. For some reason, GE Proton, which is the one you normally want to use, just doesn't work for VR, at least in my experience. This does present a temporary problem. Proton Experimental is only available through Steam, which means you will need to install Steam, sign in, and enable Proton Experimental, which will then make it show up inside of Lutris. Obviously, this is not ideal, but the bleeding edge changes in Proton Experimental should eventually make their way down to GE Proton in the future, at which point it should work for VR. At this point, you need to make sure that you have enabled developer options in your VR headset settings. Now, for Meta devices, this will mean jumping through some additional hoops, like getting a developer account. I'll leave a link in the description for how to do that. You then need to enable USB debugging in the developer options. Then, connect the headset to your PC and accept the USB debugging prompt that should appear. At this point, you need to click on the Install Wyvern button in Envision and it should work. Now you can start the Wyvern app on your headset in one of two ways. You could click on the Start Wyvern Client button right here in Envision, but that only works if the headset is connected with a wire. Right now it should be, but later on you'll be able to use it wirelessly, so it's better not to get used to this option. The better way to do it is through the headset itself. You should see a new Wyvern app in your app drawer under Unknown Sources, and that's what you should click on. Next, you need to click on the big Start button in Envision, which will pop up a 6-digit key that you need to make a note of. You also need to figure out what your PC's IP address is on the local network. There are many ways to do this, but I'll just use the IP command as shown here. On the headset itself, this is what you should be seeing. This is the Wyvern app. You need to enter the IP address of your PC like this, and then click on connect and enter the PIN code that you saw earlier. Now, we have done a lot of things so far, but most of it has just been a one-time setup. Going forward, whenever you want to play a VR game, you just need to do the last couple of steps. Number one, make sure that the Envision app is open on your PC and that you've clicked on start. And number two, make sure that the Wyvern app is open on your headset and that you've entered the PIN code to connect and pair with the PC. Finally, you're ready to play. You can go ahead and launch your game through Lutris. And as you can see, it's kind of small on the screen here, but it does look great on the device itself. Before I end the video, I do want to give a quick honorable mention to QRookie. I won't go into detail, but this is an app specifically for standalone Android headsets that lets you install various apps onto your headset that can then be used without needing a PC at all, including a lot of games. So if that's a route you want to go down, you should give that a try. And that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching.